Hey guys, Julia here. So spring cleanup continues in our garden, and today I wanted to show you some of the things that you should remember when you're doing your own spring cleanup. And what I'm going to work on today is our perennial border that is right behind me. Before I show you the lay of the land, I just wanted to tell you that spring cleanup is a very personal thing. People do it all different times of the year. You can start your spring cleanup in the fall and clean up all of your perennials then, or you can do it in the spring and leave all of the debris and the seed heads for the winter for the critters to eat and hide in. I do prefer to clean up my beds in the spring for that reason. But anyway, let me just show you the lay of the land and explain some of the things. All right, so what I'm going to do today is take a small portion of this perennial border and work little by little, because I tend to bite more than I can chew. So let's just see how much I can get done today. But my plan is to edge the other side, and I will spare you the video of that because I think you've seen enough of me edging beds. And the next step would be to clean up the border. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut all of the perennials, old growth like this phlox, for example, all the way to the bottom, and I'm going to clean up the leaves. So little side note about the leaves. I normally leave the leaves, but in this case, these are oak leaves. And oak leaves have these tannins in their leaves that make them a very leathery and really difficult to decompose. So even in the compost pile, they take forever to biodegrade. So I actually gather them up and I put them on the curb. If there were other leaves like maples or lindens, I would definitely just leave the leaves and mulch right on top of them. So that's pretty much the plan for today. So I'm just gonna get started and we'll see how far I could get. Actually, before I start, I just wanted to show you quickly the before of the area that I'm going to work on today. So lots of debris, lots of leaves, nothing is mulched. I'm still edging. And by the way, it's super busy today. Like, there are people walking around everywhere and cars. Somebody commented on one of my videos how beautiful and quiet our neighborhood is. It is actually really busy. That was a quiet day, but it is not quiet today. All right, you guys, I'm gonna take a quick break from mulching and set up these obelisks that I bought the other day. I already actually assembled two, and I'm going to put together this one. So I just wanted to show you how. All right, so generally I would not assemble anything with small parts outdoors, but these small parts that they have here, the little bolts, they're already attached, so they can't get lost. But I bought this one on hayneedle.com and it came in the mail. And I like it. I mean, it's obviously not cast iron or wrought iron, but it will do the job for my sweet peas for the border. So actually, I'm gonna stand this up. All right, so I put in the first ring already and I tightened the bolts, and three more rings to go. All right, you guys, so I put together all three of them and placed them, and I love how they turned out. I think this is a perfect support for my sweet peas. These were inexpensive. You know, they're not obviously the highest quality, but this will do just great for a couple of seasons. Oh, I love it. All right, back to mulching. All right, guys, I'm done for today. It's looking really good. Let me give you a quick tour. This is looking so much better. So I cleaned up the flocks, and this big gap right here, we used to have a panicle hydrangea right here that we replanted. So this is a vacant spot for something else. And all of the empty spaces that you see here, usually I have dahlias going in there in the summer. Now, this dead thing right here is hibiscus mosquitoes, and everybody thinks that it's dead and dead and dead, and they're waiting for it to pull it out, but it will come alive about end of May. They take their time for sure. Now, all of the little like green tufts that you see, that's feverfew, and I let it seed everywhere because it is so pretty at the end of May. Fills in the beds really, really nicely, and then I just pull it out and I leave the seedlings for the next year. Now, I love the obelisks. I think this is a great addition to this bed and definitely adds lots of structure, lots of volume, height. So what I'm going to do next, not today, in the next video, I'm actually going to plant the tulips that I have over there in these vacant spaces because I knew I will be needing some tulips. So that's when I forced those. And if you're curious about how to do it, you can just watch my video where I'm planting some pansies. And I also will be planting some sweet peas in here, right in the middle of this obelisks. Oh, and I have tons of echinaceas here because they seed themselves, and I let them seed themselves because that creates really natural and random plantings. For us humans, it's very difficult to be random, and I think random plantings are really pretty. So I just let nature do its thing. So I let some things seed, I plant some things, but in the end, it turns out really natural looking and just beautiful. Anyway, I think this is it. All right, guys, this is it for today. Thank you so much for joining me in this spring cleanup / mulch extravaganza. I hope you are gardening wherever you are. I hope you are safe. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'll see you next time. Thanks. Bye. Let me just show you the lay of the land. Oh, that was awful. Blah, 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 blah. Don't touch this thing. Little by little, are they coming this way? All right. It's running. Okay. Oh. Whoops. What was I talking about?